Black locust, Robinia pseudacacia. Distinguishing characters. The bark of the trunk is rough and deeply ridged. The buds are hardly noticeable. The twigs sometimes bear small spines on one side. The leaves are large, compound, and fern-like. The individual leaflets are small and delicate. Form and size. The locust is a medium-sized tree developing a slender, straight trunk when grown alongside of others. Range, Canada and United States. Soil and location. The locust will grow on almost any soil except a wet, heavy one. It requires plenty of light. Enemies. The locust borer has done serious damage to this tree. The grubs of this insect burrow in the sapwood and kill the tree or make it unfit for commercial use. The locust miner is a beetle which is now annually defoliating trees of this species in large numbers. Value for planting. It has little value for ornamental planting. Commercial value. Though short-lived, the locust grows very rapidly. It is extremely durable in contact with the soil and possesses great strength. It is therefore extensively grown for fence posts and railroad ties. Locust posts will last from 15 to 20 years. The wood is valuable for fuel. Other characters. The flowers are showy, pea-shaped panicles appearing in May and June. The fruit is a small pod. Other common names. Yellow locust, common locust, locust. Comparisons. The honey locust, Gledistia triacanthos, can be told from the black locust by the differences in their bark. In the honey locust, the bark is not ridged, has a sort of dark iron-gray color, and is often covered with clusters of stout, sharp, pointed thorns. The fruit is a large pod, often remaining on the tree through the winter. This tree has an ornamental, but no commercial value.